Hello, this is Paul Connett, Director of the Fluoride Action Network. Well, set your watches, ladies and gentlemen. As I speak, it's 5 p.m. Eastern Time in the United States on Thursday, June the 4th. Our trial, which we've worked 20 years for, starts on Monday, June the 8th. We will be sending out how you can watch the whole trial on Zoom. Look out for our bulletins. But yes, this is the culmination of 20 years of work. Since 2000, we have been talking about the neurotoxicity of fluoride. And the number of studies has grown and grown and grown from India, from China, Iran, and Mexico. And most importantly, since 2017, the most important studies have been coming out from Canadian and American researchers. The experts, many of the experts that will be testifying in our trial wrote those papers. Bruce Lamphere, Howard Hugh, and Philippe Grandjean. You can watch it all unfold next week on Zoom. We're not certain at this point whether we can videotape the trial or whether how much delay there will be before a videotape of the trial will be available. But these are exciting days for us. I have longed for a level playing field where our science, the science that we've researched, can be put on the same level playing field with the science of the proponents, particularly the regulatory agencies like the EPA, who run interference for this wretched practice of water fluoridation. I've wanted these to be put on a level playing field and having some kind of judge. And here, in this case, we have a federal law judge who is going to determine which body of science is most convincing. Can we convince the judge, the court? Can we convince the court that A, fluoride is neurotoxic? Don't think there's a problem with that. Two, can we show that it poses an unreasonable risk, a risk at the levels at which people are exposed to in fluoridated communities? We think the latest studies, US-funded studies, allow us to do that. And so the third thing we have to persuade the judge is that this is an unreasonable risk. This is not the only way that people can get fluoride if they want it, because you can get fluoride from toothpaste and brush it on your teeth and spit it out. There is no need, judge, court, to put it in the drinking water. That's our case in a nutshell. We think we're going to win. But whether we win or lose this case, our job, the Fluoride Action Network, is not going to be over. We're going to need to continue to educate the public and educate the bodies that are currently promoting fluoridation. We particularly need to arm the activists in New Zealand, in Australia, in England, in Ireland, in Canada, in America, wherever else they fluoridate the water. We've got to educate them on this body of evidence. And this is going to be tough. We're going to need to keep going. And that's why we are running our mid-year fundraiser. To buttress, we had a fundraiser last December, but we fell short of our goal. We hope to make up for it in this month of June and maybe early July. So we hope, if you are as inspired by as we are with the fact that we've got to this point, that 20 years has brought us to this federal court action, if you're excited by that, then please trust us. We've put a professional team together, a great team, that will continue to educate the public and continue to educate governments around the world that this plan of putting fluoride in the water is a foolish policy. It should never have started. But now that we have the scientific evidence, there is no excuse for continuing this in any country. So please enjoy the trial. We hope we'll enjoy it. Enjoy the trial, and please just spare a few pennies to keep our operation going. I think you'll agree that we deserve it once you watch this trial. Thank you very much.